A sample of copper absorbs 43.6 kilojoules of heat, resulting in a temperature rise of 75 degrees Celsius. Determine the mass in kilograms of the copper sample if the specific heat capacity of copper is 0.385. How to do this type of questions? So the first thing we need to know the equation that we will be using, which is Q equal MC delta T. Q is the energy transferred, and this has to be in joules. M is the mass, and that has to be in grams. C, it's the specific heat capacity, and delta T has to be in Kelvin or Celsius. So let's check the given values in this question. So in the question, it says a sample of copper absorbs 43.6 kilojoules of heat. So this is the heat transferred, but notice that it's in kilojoules and we need it in joules. So starting by the Q, and in the question, it says 43.6 kilojoules. So I need to transfer this to joules. I multiply by kilojoules or joules. Why I did that? So I can cancel the kilojoules, and 1 kilojoules give me 1,000 joules, and that means Q is 43.6 times 10 to the power of 3 joules. All right, so resulting in the temperature rise of 75 degrees. So delta T is a 75 degree. No conversion needed in here. Determine the mass in kilograms of the copper sample of the specific heat capacity. So a specific heat capacity is given to me as 0.385. And the unit of this is joule divided by grams Celsius. So you can just plug in the numbers in the equation and see what's M. So 43 as the Q times 10 to the power of 3. And this is the Q, this, right? And this is the value that I get from the question, equal M. And that's what I'm looking for, right? C is the specific heat, which is 0.385, multiplied by the change in temperature, which is a 75. So just dividing both sides of the equation by these numbers, I can get M. So if I did the mass of this, I will get M as 1509. But remember, what's the unit of M? It's in grams, because this equation gives me grams of mass, right? But they are asking me the mass in kilograms, so I need to convert this to a kilograms. So grams, kilograms. Why did that? I can cancel grams in this way. So 1 kilogram gives me 1,000 grams. This is my conversion factor. So just by dividing that number by 1,000, that will give me 1.509, and I can just say 1.51 kilograms. And this is the answer, and that gives me the first choice is the correct answer. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, subscribe. If you have any questions, just leave it in the comment box, and I'll be more than happy to solve them for you. Thank you.